Steven Spielberg was born in the year 1946 on December 18th in Cincinnati, Ohio. His father was Arnold Spielberg and his mother was Leah. In the late 1940s, Spielberg's father, Arnold, worked in the computer industry, and this involved a lot of traveling, and so the family kept moving from state to state. The longest place where Spielberg ever stayed was in the Phoenix, and that's where he started getting a little bit of education. Spielberg is one of the lucky few who figured out his life's calling from a very young age. At 10, he filmed the adventures of himself and his friends and charged admission to the home viewings. At around 12, he wrote and directed a 9-minute film to earn a Boy Scout photography badge. And at the age of 16, he made his first full-length film named The Firelight, which had a budget of $500 and was shown at his local cinema. As he grew up, Spielberg wanted to do a graduation in filmmaking, for which he applied to the University of Southern California. There, his application got rejected 3 times, after which he got dropped out from his school and thought of becoming a director. His career as a director started in the year 1968 with the film Amblin. Having a terrific career opening and working in a lot of short films and televisions, Spielberg's first big break was to direct the first feature film called The Sugarland Express. And the movie was well received and it had a lot of critics, but it was a box office flop and it received only a limited release. This experience of failure left Spielberg disappointed and more determined than ever to produce a hit. He expressed interest in a script about a killer shark and was chosen to direct it. Everyone knows that film as Jaws and was one of the greatest hit, and Spielberg was around 27 years old when this movie hit the screen. Film Jaws was plagued with a lot of problems because of the main character, which was the mechanical shark called the Bruce. The production was planned for 55 days, but the shooting dragged out to nearly 159 days. And because of this, Spielberg had a really bad name. Finally, after the long wait, when the film was released, it was a huge success. Spielberg had made many mistakes that he knew were unexpectable during the shooting of Jaws. Yet in the end, the film succeeded. But as the lessons, he learned how to respect the deadlines, how to stay within the budget, and how to accept critics positively. Sometimes, success itself is a successful person's worst enemy. Declining offers for several would-be blockbusters, Spielberg instead started his own production on the name called 1941, the World War II movie that poked fun at the Americans' fear of the Japanese after the bombing of Pearl Harbor. It was filled with bombs and roids and exploding aircrafts and general destruction. The movie became one of the worst flops in Spielberg's career because it suffered a lack of vision and purpose. However, this man, Spielberg, allowed himself to learn from his mistakes and come out stronger on the other side. Spielberg's career once again took off, but this time it was far more balanced. There were no more production issues, no more crew problems, and no more ego. He was able to balance the art and science of filmmaking and went on to become one of the greatest directors of all time. Of the noteworthy movies are The Extraterrestrial, released in the year 1982, The Twilight Zone in 1983, The Indiana Jones in 1984, Jurassic Park in 1993, and Catch Me If You Can in 2002. He always had a thought that his parents had struggled a lot to give education to him, but he was not able to gain the graduation, which was a pain in his heart. And so, to let go of the pain, he underwent the graduation program, and in the year 2002, he successfully completed his graduation in BA. When Spielberg had won 3 Oscars in his career, one of which was given for the movie Jaws. From being the successful director, Spielberg also takes care of a lot of charities across the United States. He and his wife is funded a lot of cancer institutions. The couple have also funded education in arts and filmmaking for students from underprivileged background. You see, the greatest people in history have always been failures. We only see them as successful legends and overlook their failures. Failures should not be overlooked in anyone, especially not in the people that we admire. It is through failure that these individuals are able to learn, to grow, and to ultimately succeed. From this motivating life story of Spielberg, we can learn that nothing is impossible in this world. Whether you get rejected in your school or college, whether you fail in making your first few films, you can still dream about being one of the most successful directors in the world. And so he did. Spielberg not only succeeded as a director, but also as a human. He understood the values and the needs of the human beings around them and came forward to help them in the name of charity. We all appreciate this great deed of Steven Spielberg, and we look forward for a successful career to continue in the years coming. Hey guys, I hope you all like this great story of the great man Steven Spielberg. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel for inspirational stories like this one. We post from Monday to Friday and help you keep yourself power packed always. So we'll meet you in our next video. Until then, take care. Bye bye.